Colgate football means tradition. When young men wear the Red Raider jersey, they represent more than the present program. They evoke images of past players, men like Eugene Robinson, Mark Van Egan, and Mark Murphy, all of whom went on to greatness in the National Football League. But Colgate University first stands for a great education, and playing for second-year head coach Ed Sweeney and his demanding staff, that means learning how to play hard. In 1994, the Patriot League took notice of that work ethic, that the greatness of Colgate's past will soon be in its future. With a state-of-the-art weight facility, which Colgate players hit year-round nearly as hard as the books, Coach Sweeney and his team have laid the foundation for one of the best 1AA programs in the country. The belief at Colgate is that the pride is back.
Pride on three, baby. Pride on three. One, two, three. Pride!
Yeah, baby! Get the first ball.
Andy Kerr Stadium, opening day for Colgate and Boston University. Ed Sweeney helped lead the Terriers to 6 Yankee Conference titles in 7 years as a defensive coordinator. But today, he and his old mates didn't see eye to eye. At the start of the 105th season of football at Colgate, the Red Raiders' prayers were not answered. In the first series, Damon Smith went down with a season-ending knee injury. Enter sophomore Anthony Caravetta. The slashing tailback from New Jersey scored the Red Raiders' first touchdown of the season.
McDuffie takes the snap and he hands off to Caravetta. Caravetta gets through a big hole, breaks a couple tackles, breaks two more. He's across the 35, the 30. He's going to go all the way for the touchdown and a great run. First, second, third, fourth effort, a 53-yard touchdown run by Anthony Caravetta.
But Caravetta's run didn't spell out victory. Despite a great effort from the special teams, Colgate kicked off the season with a loss.
He's in a building process. They're going to be. There's great tradition here at Colgate. They're going to be fine.
What I'm hoping for is that you play your second game, and you that's where you see most of your improvement.
Improving against Dartmouth would be no easy task. With Damon Smith out for the season, Colgate relied on a new offensive weapon. Freshman quarterback Mark Lindell. But the Big Green opened the scoring, though the damage could have been worse. In Dartmouth's second possession, the Red Raiders raided the pocket, forcing just a field goal. Dartmouth's next possession, same result. This time, Tom Rossi squelched the drive. Dartmouth would grab a commanding 16-0 lead before freshman Mark Lindell found the mark.
Hope is in the slot, Nash is the wide man. That's where Lindell looks. Flips it to Hope. Hope is through the secondary. He's to the 35, to the 30. Hope is to the 20. One man to catch him, and he's not going to do it. Hope with the touchdown.
The big play that Lindell and I had in the first half, I mean, if hadn't that happened, I think the game might have been different. I mean, we had to get some points on the board before the half.
Sweeney elected to go for two, and Nash found Joe Castagna on a tackle eligible. The conversion provided more life for the Red Raiders, and more important, cut the lead to 16-8 at half. On the first possession of the second half, Tom Nash dogged the Big Green D.
Fake on this one. Lindell slips, regains his footing.
Oh,
he's got
man.
Nash. He's gone. Tommy Nash on the touchdown reception from 36 yards out, and the freshman quarterback has two big touchdown plays on the afternoon. Lindell has got this team moving.
We just came up with it at halftime and just worked. I don't know what else to say. Nash made a great catch.
More hope was on the way. J.J. Hope's third down reception kept a drive alive. Time for the knockout punch. Coach Sweeney got it from Jamal Patterson. His first career touchdown gave Colgate its first lead of the season, 20-16. But with under 3 minutes to go, Dartmouth drove to the Colgate 2-yard line. Then the Red Raider defense flexed its muscles.
He's got Shearer to his right. They go option, and he slips on the turf and falls, knocked down in the backfield, and that will do it on that drive.
Came to play and, you know, just finished him off, I guess. And just made the big play when we had to.
Colgate needed one more big play on Dartmouth's final possession.
Riley back to pass. This could be the game. Intercepted by Morelli. Morelli has it at the 30. He's got running room to the 40. Morelli goes down, now knocked out of the bounds at the 45-yard line. Tom Morelli, the big interception, and Ren Riley sitting on the ground, on the sidelines, dejected.
Junior Tom Morelli's interception ended any ideas of a Dartmouth comeback. The Patriot League Defensive Player of the Week came off the bench to add 10 tackles as the Red Raiders tackled Dartmouth 20-16.
Kids concentrated, everybody was into it on the sidelines, the coaches were into it. And it was a situation where I think the kids just decided they're not going to lose a football game.
Colgate left home and kicked off a four-game road trip. While the results at Princeton, Brown, Buffalo, and Harvard proved unfavorable, scoreboards can't measure development. Decimated by injuries, the four-week stretch instead signified the emergence of Dana Farland. Once listed fourth on the depth chart at tailback, the little guy from Massachusetts played big in place of Anthony Caravetta. After scoring the lone gate touchdown at Brown, the 5'6", 170-pound senior ripped off 169 yards at Buffalo and 153 more at Harvard. Good for Patriot League Player of the Week honors. With an unlikely new weapon, the Red Raiders return home with their sights set on a Patriot League championship. That confidence had a friendly ring to it for Colgate fans. The start of Patriot League play and the belief that this team could contend for a conference championship.
One thing we've been able to do, even though we haven't been winning the last few weeks, is practice hard.
That work paid dividends. Tom Nash, who missed the Harvard game with an injury, worked his way down the sidelines on the opening series. His 79-yard reception set up a touchdown by DJ Huff. Then senior safety Dan Walker, who persevered until his senior year for a chance to start, came up with a big play. His interception gave Colgate the football, and Dana Farland knew where to go with it. He rushed for 59 of his 117 yards on this carry. It set up Colgate's second touchdown.
Duffy takes the snap. He rolls out, looking in the end zone. He throws it up, and it is complete to Hope. Touchdown. Nice catch, nice throw, nice work. Colgate goes up by a score of 13-0.
McDuffie picking up where he left off last week, looking very solid at quarterback on that touchdown play.
With the defense shutting down the Fordham attack, senior quarterback Bill McDuffie, back in as the starter, looks solid again.
McDuffie takes the snap. He rolls left, looking for Tommy Nash. Passes up, and it is caught. Touchdown! Colgate Red Raiders.
It works to perfection again, huh? Air Sweeney, I kind of like it.
You like that?
I kind of like it.
We could go with Air Gibson, too, the offensive coordinator for the Red Raiders.
I'll tell you, the last couple of weeks, the offense have really made dramatic strides ahead.
Ahead 21-0 at half, Colgate watched Fordham make their best plays with their feet. Yet the Rams didn't have the foot speed to catch Jamal Patterson. The sophomore reached the pylon for the second time on the season.
Hope is wide right, Nash is wide left, two tight ends. Patterson on the carry, he's got it up for the first down. He's across the 40, across the 45, across the 30, across the 25. Touchdown, Jamal Patterson, high-stepping the last 5 yards.
Don't pull a groin high-stepping.
Oh, he gets down there, and boy, I tell you, what a run by Patterson. A big hole. One man in the backfield, and he high-steps the last 5 yards.
Let's go, Brandon Smalley!
Mike Foreman and the offense sensed victory. They huddled and sniffed out another touchdown.
McDuffie takes the snap. He rolls out right. He's looking. He steps. He throws. He's got a man deep. And it is Tom Nash. What a great catch by Tom Nash. Touchdown!
What a great catch.
Tommy Nash did it all. Oh, he's trying to do a little dance down there, too.
And that's Tommy Nash's fourth reception on the day. That puts him
in the top 10 all-time receiving for the Colgate Red Raiders.
The way I did it felt really good with the touchdown and everything. It means a lot to me to be in the top 10, but to be honest with you, I'm more happy about the win than anything.
While Nash was breaking records, the defense was breaking down Fordham. The only Rams score came on a fumble recovery.
I'm real tired, but it's been a long day. And I beat you.
Yeah, you know that good.
I'm very tired, huh?
Marcus Cameron and a worn-out defense had accomplished its mission.
Goose egg!
It's a shutout. There's nothing better for a defense than shutting an opponent out.
We've talked about it in the last couple of weeks, and to finally be able to do it in league play, homecoming, that's even sweeter.
Even with a commanding 35-6 lead, coverages remain tight.
Right now!
Not all of the players and coaches.
So low! How old are you? Hey, look! Who's got more hair on their head? Who's got more hair? That's going to be on the highlight.
Come on, coach!
Hey, I'm still good looking. No problem with that. It's distinguished.
Mike Borman is also very distinguished in the classroom, where he maintains a 3.9 GPA in psychology. And as an all-league offensive lineman and captain, he psychs up the Red Raiders.
You know, to be chosen captain at any position is great, especially as an old lineman, you know. It's the truth. You never get any credit. Not that's what I've ever looked for out of this game. It's just always meant a lot to me because it's really taught me discipline and how to live life, really, to go after everything with everything you have.
Colgate did just that against Fordham, battering the Rams 35-6.
You'll never beat us again in the junkyard. Never, ever. Never, ever will they ever beat us again.
Game ball. I'll get it painted up for him. Got himself in the record books today.
Nash, where's he?
Tom Nash held on to everything all season.
Let's go, guys, let's go!
I want to come out and play as hard as I can. And when I'm not here next year, I don't want to have any regrets when I look back on things.
Like Nash, fellow senior Tom Rossi left everything he had on the football field. The defensive end was anything but a quarterback's friend.
I said there was gonna be a lot of dancing going on.
You should say hi to Mom.
Oh, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Mom, Fabio says hi.
You never know when your last play is gonna be. And you have to play like everyone is your last. We just keep, that's all week through practice. Never try to take a play off.
After its win over Fordham, the next week at Lehigh, Coach Sweeney showed what his program is all about. Trailing the Engineers by 3 with under a minute to play, he chose to go for a win rather than a game-tying field goal. Colgate lost the game, but won over anyone who doubted their will to win. The Red Raiders would need that fight to get past Lafayette at home the following week. And that determination was personified by one of the smallest Red Raiders, Dana Farland.
I'm just, you know, very thankful I had the opportunity to come out and prove what I always thought I could do. And hopefully I can, as an offense, they can get another 1,000-yard running back this year.
Farland picked up a big chunk of that yardage on Colgate's opening series. The result, Gates' first points of the day.
Nash has set the hole at the 19, so a 29-yard attempt for Franco. The kick is up. And it is good.
Steve Franco's 29-yard field goal put Colgate ahead 3-0. Protecting a 3-0 lead, the defense shut down all-league tailback Eric Marsh on the first few series. Senior defensive end Aaron Coretti was a big reason why. An anchor on the line all season, he turned into a cheerleader when Colgate got the ball back.
He's tackled, loses the football, Colgate recovers!
Like Pito, offensive tackle R.J. Colosimo stepped his game up in his final season. The senior helped open the holes that set up Colgate's second score of the day.
So a 31-yard attempt for Franco. The kick is up. And it is good.
Colgate carried a 6-0 lead into half. but was knocked off by two big second half plays, 14-6. Still, players like junior tight end John O'Flynn, who caught five passes, continued to improve.
Well, we have young players who are getting a lot of game experience, and you know, we're making mistakes, but you know, you hope that those younger players learn from that experience.
We just got to push forward. I mean, I have two more games left, and I just want to make sure that before I leave, I can establish some kind of winning attitude here, and that's the most important thing to me right now.
Colgate established that attitude early against Bucknell. Leading 3-0 on the road, Anthony Caravetta, who finished with 152 yards on just 10 carries, took off down the sideline. His run set up Colgate's first touchdown. Bill McDuffie hit Tom Nash from 37 yards out over the middle. It was the fifth touchdown of the season for Nash and the eighth of his brilliant career. Second half up 10-7, Colgate broke it wide open.
Caravetta will carry, bust into the secondary, 50, it's a foot race, 40, 30, inside the Bucknell 20.
Caravetta's 56-yard run set up a touchdown for freshman DJ Huff.
And it's going to be Huff, and that's the touchdown. And the freshman has now carried 18 times and has six touchdowns.
A short yardage specialist, Huff wasn't huffing and puffing. He ran another one in.
Another touchdown for the freshman.
The rest of the day was left up to the defense. Sophomore Marcus Cameron picked off two passes. Cameron, who also had five tackles and a pass breakup, earned Patriot League Defensive Player of the Week honors.
There's good coverage, and it'll be intercepted by Marcus Cameron.
Dana Farland capped the afternoon off with a touchdown. He, too, went over the 100-yard mark with 110 on 24 carries. Colgate and Rob Howard picked off the Bison 31-7.
Showtime!
Showtime and the last chance for 12 seniors to show off their stuff to the Colgate fans. The Holy Cross Crusaders at Colgate. The fans were treated to some individual great performances. Dana Farland capped his senior year by eclipsing 1,000 yards.
When I came in, you know, fall camp, I was, you know, the last tailback in the depth chart, and you know, I just kept on pushing through all the way through, and you know, I ended up with a 1,000-yard season.
Defensively, Colgate knocked the heads off Holy Cross. Play after play, the defense made big stops. Yeah. Holy Cross couldn't shut down Bill McDuffie and J.J. Hope. The two connected on Gates' first and only touchdown in the second half. Hope is one reason that Colgate has high hopes for next season. Another, junior linebacker Tom Morelli. His interception against the Crusaders helped him earn second-team All-Patriot League honors. He rejoins the team next year along with first-team All-Leaguer Marcus Cameron, who led the Patriot League with four interceptions. But the seniors will be missed. Players like first-team All-Patriot League receiver Tom Nash and first-team All-League offensive linemen R.J. Colissimo and Mike Borman. Dana Farland and Dan Walker also earned second-team honors and depart. And while Colgate didn't send the seniors out with a win, they left with lots of memories. Players like number 99, Pat Pito, and Andre Martin, who had a hard time leaving the field he loved.
All the friends I met, I mean, I had so much fun here. First, I never liked it when I came here, but then I just came close as a team.
Well, it hurts, you know. I've been playing this game since we were eight, and, you know, it's like a part of your dying. It's not like any other sport.
I love football more than anything in the world. And, you know, it's taught me a lot. And I guess I just got to take that and move on.
I hope they learned a little bit about working very hard for a specific goal. And taking that out into the job market, that to be successful, you have to outwork some people at times. You can't take anything for granted. And if you do your job, things are going to work out for you.
Things didn't always work out according to plan in 1994, but the pride is back at Colgate, and the future looks bright. We'll be right back.
And beginning of next year, you're going to see the team coming out ready to play. They're going to learn from their lessons. And like I said, I can see it going nothing but up with Coach Sweeney.
It's been the greatest 4 years of my life. I wouldn't trade this for anyone in the world.
I know the types of players that are coming back next year, and they're not quitters. And I'll tell you what, these guys are gonna come back next year and do some good things.
Coach Sweeney's instilled some great, great things in this program. You know, this year I think we became a team.